Would you look at that conference ceiling? Look at that chandelier. Excuse me, but how I'm feeling is 100 proof. I can raise the roof. I'm so happy to be here. I grew up in LA, and I went to this like hippy dippy school in Santa Monica that we got all these like Jewish holidays off. There it is. And my mom would take me to New York City on these long weekends, and we would see like 5 shows in a weekend. And I'd spend all of my time in Times Square. So from then on, I thought of New York as Times Square. And it's, I know it's not an incredibly popular belief that, you know, Times Square is the greatest place in the world, but it is, and I love it. I've been kind of missing Mom and Daddy, sort of in a spin since Cincinnati. The morning flight, a major blur, but then they open the cabin door and suits of war. Here I am, and all through college I just was dying to get here. I almost didn't come back after my freshman year because I just wanted to be here. I'm a total city girl, and Ann Arbor was just not cutting it. So when I got here and got cast in Phantom and got to work in Times Square, it couldn't have been more perfect. Lord knows I had the will and the resources, but Mom and Dad kept saying, hold your horses. I guess those ponies couldn't wait. Pardon me, folks, because I left the gate. I may be late, but here I am. The way to me is New York. The way they scream at me is New York. So here I am. Hello, Times Square. I'm not going anywhere. I'm only dreaming. Please don't wake me. Let the crowded trains and buses take me. Excuse me if I seem shoo-shoon. I promise I'll find my normal soon. But everywhere I look, it's like a scene from a book. Open the book. I'm in the longest running show. But for tonight, it feels so